Hello everyone, I welcome you to yet another episode of Fridays with Dhawale. I am Dr. Vijaya Patil. I am practicing classical homeopathy since 30 years and I am also working with special children at my center, Sparsh Homeopathy and Child Care Center. So today we are going to discuss a case of dissociative fugue. So what we will discuss today is key how to understand the presentation of a dissociative fugue state in a child. Also, we will experience the challenges we will face in understanding the psyche of the child, the psychosocial stresses, as well as the importance of coping mechanism. Also, further, what are the difficulties we face in formulation of the totality in a child where so many mental symptoms are present. Also, we will learn to spot similarity at different levels and tip into very less frequently used remedies. And finally, we will also learn differential materia medica from the study of this case. So we will move towards the case. He is a child of 14 years old. He is studying in 9th standard and father is employed in bank and mother is a housewife. So what was the concern of this parent? He till 6th standard, he was very good at studies, but since 3 years, his academic performance is going down from A to C grade. Now, what was the most concern here is that in the last 3 months, there are 3 fleeing episodes. What are these fleeing episodes? Like he will suddenly get away from school or from home without telling anybody. He will roam around at very unknown places and for hours and hours. And when asked he what you are doing here, why you have come here, who has brought you here, he will not be able to answer. He will also will not be able to answer ki what is the reason you are here. And every time somebody or the other brought him home, you know. So and when after coming home also, if you ask him, then he will not remember anything ki where he had gone and what he has done there. So these were the type of episodes he was having. I will describe all the 3 episodes in detail, like what happened. According to parents, there were always reason for these episodes. Like the first episode happened when he failed in history and science. So somebody noticed him that he was roaming around at one place. So he was taken to the police station and there he said, I was kidnapped. So there was a school authorities were called and the issue was resolved with that. See, he was having the school badge at that time. So from that, they called the school authorities and the issue was resolved. The second episode, again, he was not prepared for the exams. And he was roaming around. Then one rickshaw driver spotted him and he left him home. And the parents were searching for him for the whole day. The third episode, again, was like this, that he was roaming around without anybody's knowledge. At that day, what had happened that teachers had scolded him and has kept his calendar. So, but every time you ask him ki whether why you went there, whether you were disturbed because of this punishment or you had fear of punishment or you had fear that somebody will scold you. But he says, ki, no, I don't know anything why I was there at those places. So he will completely forget about the incidents. So the patient was interviewed and what he says, what he said that my mother says that I have to ask for the books if it is not completed from my classmate, but I don't want to ask for the books. I don't want to bow down in front of anybody and I don't want to ask for help. So in that sense, I am very egoistic. If you tease me, if you contradict me, if you don't allow me to do what I want, then I will beat back that child and I will be tit for tat. So that way he himself understands that I become very angry and I am not able to control my anger. But at the same time, he said that nowadays I am feeling that I am losing control over my anger and I don't want to do it. I don't want to be tit for tat, but I am not able to control my anger. Other thing what he said, that when the teacher is teaching, I get absorbed in my thoughts. I am not able to concentrate. And I also have difficulties in memorizing things as well as difficulty in maths. This was the information which was collected from the child. About asking what you like, what are your hobbies? Then he said, ki, I am very much interested in army, the guns, the shooting, the violence. I like adventurous things, rock climbing, dangerous things. In terms of movies also, he likes to see movies related to army, adventure. And he said, ki, I like to go to new places and to foreign countries. So these were the information from the child. From mother. Mother said that he is the only child and I have to be very strict with him because he is very obstinate. He will, if he wants, he wants. He will not comply. And that's why I have to be very strict with him. If his wishes are not fulfilled, then he will become very angry. He will throw all the temper tantrums like banging the door, breaking things, striking himself also. At school also, there are so many complaints because he will get into quarrels with other children. Once he wanted to put his bag at one place and the classmate did not allow him. So the classmate was beaten very, there was a issue and the issue was taken to the principal and the parents were called. So there were so many such issues like that, you know. So he used to be tit for tat. Mother said he is very tit for tat and he will not forget. Also, mother said ki he is always complaining about people. You know, he is like this, he is like this, he has done this to me. Once the teacher scolded the whole class because the food was spilled over the benches. So she scolded the whole class, but he got so disturbed. He came home, he was grumbling and he was abusing the teacher. So this is the information we got from the mother. So when he was sitting in front of me, I could see the observation which were made by me that he was very fidgety. There were constant movement of his hands, his feet and all. There was a constant, you know, his finger was in his hair. He was pulling the hair. He was rolling the hairs. Also in front of me also, he was not very conscious that I'm sitting in front of a doctor, you know. He was just stretching his bodies here and there. And he looked very confident to me. So these were the observation made by me during the interview. In terms of physical characteristic, if we see, there were not much characteristics available, but I could get that there was some aversion to milk. On his nails, there were a lot of white spots, which came into my observations. And he had tendency past history of tonsillitis as well as loose motions. I also collected the birth history and the developmental history, but nothing significant was available in that. So I moved ahead, you know, from diagnosis point of view. Now, if we read the DSM-4 criteria for the dissociative fugue, I'll just read the criteria quickly. There is unexpected travel from home or one's customary place, daily activity with inability to recall some or all of the one's incidents, accompanied by confusion of identity or new identity, and symptom must cause clinically significant distress or impairment in social or other important areas of functioning. And it should not occur under the effect of any medication or other dissociative identity disorder. So if we compare now these criteria with our patient, so we see a lot of similarity. There was an unexpected travel from home. It was accompanied by confusion. It was accompanied by, you know, short-term amnesia. And it was causing a significant distress in his academic performance, in his social relationship, as well as personal areas. So from all this, we came to the diagnosis of dissociative fugue. The school counselor was also working on him. And the counseling was going on since 3 months, but there was no effect. And the fleeing attacks were continued. So after understanding this child, we understood that this child is very egoistic, very haughty. He is dominating, obstinate, impatient, anger, temper, tantrum, striking, everything. As I told you in the previous slides, that everything was there. He was complaining about everyone. At the same time, he had fear of losing his anger. He had desire to pull hairs. He wanted to escape and run away from the situation. He had desire to travel foreign countries, and there was aversion to milk. So the prescription was given on the same day of the case taking. So these were the things which were taken in totality, and the repertorization was done. So what is our repertorization? What are the drugs which are coming in our repertorization? The first drug which is coming is Merck. You know, and as we understand the image of Merck, like, they are very haughty, they are very courageous, they are insolent, they are rude, there is rage, striking, destructiveness. So all was fitting into Merck. The symptom that, desire escaped to, that was also covered by Merck. The aversion milk was also covered by Merck. So Merck seems to me the most suitable remedy for this case. Other remedies were, differentiated, like Nux Vomica. Nux Vomica has, need for name, fame, money, and there's a lot of fastidiousness, which was missing in this case. Lachesis, though this case appears as a very malicious, but he was not jealous. He was not suspicious. Like, from on that basis, Lachesis was ruled out. Belladonna has very episodic, lot of violence and very episodic, So I felt the Merck is the most suitable remedy for this case, and Merck was prescribed. So Merck was given for 2 months, 6 doses of Merck Sol the patient had taken. And what is the follow-up? The follow-up is that the fleeing episodes are continuously there, one episode of escaping. So instead of going to the class, he roamed around for 5 hours in rickshaw. The second episode also happened, and he was brought back by somebody to home. So the parents were very much concerned. They said ki there is no change in his behavior, his obstinacy, his anger, temper tantrum levels. So again, the totality was reviewed. Now it was reviewed from more specific point of view. See, if you remember this interview of the child, where he said that I like army, I like guns, I like police, violence. So all that was depicting as if he wants to be a commander, he wants to be an officer. So that was again taken into consideration. He, why this child is behaving like this, how a commander behaves. This was his fantasies, that how a commander, he wants to be a commander, and his behavior were also impressed with that feeling. Like, he was haughty, he is dictatorial, he is obstinate, he wants to command. So this point was taken in consideration now in this review of totality. Again, this is a commander which has very sensitivity to insult, sensitivity to reprimand, contradiction, confrontation. So this was a general who has this sensitivity. And also, this is a general who has this intellectual part, which is slightly weakness of memory, absent-mindedness, decreased concentration, confusion, everything. And if we now see at the expression levels, the anger, the temper tantrum, the destructiveness, the discontentment, the fleeing episode, how he escapes, there is a lot of confusion. There is short-term amnesia. And again, at the expression level, pulling hairs, stretching, fidgeting, difficulty in maths, headaches, does not want to be tit for tat. All these expressions were again studied with respect to repertorization as well as materia medica. And also in this totality were included the white spots on nails. So this is the repertorial totality, a new repertorial totality after the review. The first and the foremost thing here is delusion. He is general, he is commander. And that gives him the quality of dictatorial, haughty, obstinate, along with the rage, striking and beating. Okay. Then the other things like malicious, tit for tat, complaining about everything, escape desire to in delirium, escape desire to have many remedies, but escape desire to in delirium, like a confused state, only 2-3 remedies are there. Also fear of losing control of self, stretching desire to pull hair, desire to nail white spots and aversion. So this was the new totality after the review. And what is our repertorization now? So the first drug after the review is coming, the first drug which is coming is Cuprum. See, Cuprum had come up in that repertorization also. It was fifth in that repertorization, but at that time it was not there in my mind, you know, and I did not do a depth study at that time when I had prescribed Merxol. But then later on I studied it from all the books and I was convinced that this patient is not Merck and he is Cuprum. Like how I studied, like if you read Hahnemann's chronic diseases, see here I have not put anything of my words, you know, or from the case. What Hahnemann's proving symptoms: fits of insanity, thinks himself military, surly, ill-natured, frightened confusion of mind, he seeks to escape. These are all proving symptoms, you know, the language of the proving symptoms. Forgets everything for a short period, irresolute, does not know what he wants, and dissatisfied with everything. He is restless, tossing, and constant uneasiness. These are the words of proving from Hahnemann's chronic diseases. Now, I again studied this drug from T.F. Allen's encyclopedia, where more symptoms are available. And I had put it in different facets so as to make it easy, the understanding. What is written is fantasies, military commander. These are also proving symptoms, words, sensitive, easily get insulted or criticized, obstinate and rigid. At the level of expression, you see the anger, violence, malicious, fear of losing control of himself, obstinate with cheerfulness, wants to control anger, does not want to be tit for tat. Loses in terms of intellect, there is weakness of memory, absent-mindedness, confusion, and irresolute. These are all the words taken from proving symptoms. He loses the thoughts for a short period, insanity, stupidity with headache, does not know what he wants. No? And the at the level of behavior, there is a lot of restlessness, which is mimicked in fidgety, stretching, pulling hairs, kicks, spits, punch, shouts. He escapes or hides. There were many alternating states also present in Cuprum, but only one alternating state which I could see in this child is that I don't want to lose control over my anger. I don't want to be tit for tat. But at the same time, he was doing that things. Okay, so this was the study done from T.F. Allen's encyclopedia. So on that basis, you know, repertorization as well as the study from the Materia Medica, Cuprum met 200, two doses were given weekly. And now we see the follow-ups. It is on your screen. You know, the last follow-up was on after, I think, 5 months, 5.5 months. And in this period, there are no episodes of fleeing. So after that two doses, only placebo was given. In the third or fourth month, he had one acute, which was covered with pulsatilla. And then again, two doses of Cuprum Med was repeated. And later on, there are, after 15-3, the patient, I did not see the patient. See, this patient was brought to me, referred to me by one of my colleague friend, because she was going to USA and she was knowing that this child is having this problem. So she told me that you handle this case, okay? So after 15-3-14, the case was again shifted back to that friend, my colleague, okay? So recently I talked to that friend, okay, what happened to that child, you know, after he left from me. So she said he was very fine. He was doing very great in his studies also. And last she remembered he took admission in engineering, and afterwards she lost the thread of this patient. So we know that this patient did well after Cuprum met. Okay. So after this case, you know, after the detailed study of this case, what we learn from this case, first and foremost, the knowledge of clinical psychiatry is very necessary to understand the case, to diagnose, to know the depth of the disease, as well as to know the prognosis of the disease. also the case taking, the importance of the evolutionary aspect of case taking, you know, to know the stresses on this child and to know the response. The evolutionary aspect is very important from clinical point of view as well as from the homeopathic point of view. And after taking the case, you know, the importance of this predisposing attributes, the exciting causes, and the morbid mental state together in reaching to the similarity. Because we have to strike the similarity at all the levels. We have to strike the similarity at the level of mental state, at the level of attributes, at the level of expressions. Okay, so this case taking and this formulation of totality is very important to reach to our similima. In this case, the most important thing was the delusion that he is a commander. And many of his attributes were related to that commander. But at the same time, this commander was very sensitive to criticism and very sensitive to confrontation. Okay, and maybe there were fears also of fear of punishment or fear of reprimand. But all those fears, this patient never accepted that I am having these fears. Okay, so we in this case, the totality was at the level of mental state, at the level of attributes, at the level of expressions. The expressions were also very qualified. You know, a commander will never give a flight response. A commander will always give a fight response. But here was a commander who was giving a flight response in a situation of danger. So this was also a very characteristic expression of cuprum. He escaping in delirium with confusion and with short-term amnesia. So the cuprum was fitting at the level of attributes, at the level of mental state, at the level of expressions. And because it was fitting at all the levels, it could do wonders. And finally, the most important is the PQR. So there are so many symptoms, but in all that symptom, we have to find out what is the PQRS, because many drugs were coming at the general level. But if we consider the PQRS symptom of this case as delusion commander, the fleeing episodes, the, you know, restlessness, the pulling hairs, the stretching at the expression level, then on these PQRS, we were able to come to cuprum met. Finally, I am very helpful to Dr. MLD Trust for giving me this opportunity to share my experience. I am very thankful to all my teachers and especially Dr. Praful Barwalia, as he was my first teacher and mentor. And above all, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann for giving us this wonderful science. So with this, I will conclude my presentation. Have a good day.